plastic surgeons nationwide say they are seeing more patients who want facial surgery to make them look better on social media.
Not in person? Well, from selfies to Instagram to FaceTime, we're constantly seeing a reflection of ourselves. So Amy Frazier goes beyond the headlines tonight to find out what you need to know if you're considering the Facebook facelift.
I asked a local plastic surgeon about this trend and safety considerations when it comes to having plastic surgery or other facial treatments. I also met with a local mom and CFO who has felt the sometimes self-conscious sting of social media.
This is pretty hideous after just running the marathon.
Running marathons is one of the ways Betty Lou Morrow of Canby stays young and healthy from the inside out.
And my mother says I run from things literally and figuratively.
But one thing she hasn't been able to run from is social media.
All of your friends are posting pictures, and of course, they get to filter the ones that make them look best. And you look at your, oh my God, where did you find that picture of me?
I met with Dr. James Chan, a board-certified facial plastic surgeon in Clackamas, to see if he's seeing an increase in patients wanting facial procedures to look better online.
We see this every day, practically.
Do you have any concerns about that?
For us, it doesn't change the process by which we talk to patients and counsel them. You know, they've thought about this for a while, and it's something that realistically we can help them with.
Still, Betty Lou says she can relate to a recent national survey pointing to a rising trend in patients unhappy about their own image, reflected through selfies and social media tools.
So I hate FaceTime because I can't stand that reflection of myself back at me.
You better not cringe tonight when you
see this. I'm not
going
to watch it.
Really?
I'm not. No, really, I'm not. I'm absolutely not going to do it.
You're gorgeous.
Well,
oh my
it's
gosh.
Awfully nice.
For those who are considering facial procedures, Dr. Chan says it's important to research and interview doctors, making sure they're qualified.
And one way you can research doctors, really of any kind, is to go to the Oregon Medical Board's website. We put a link for you on our website at coin.com. Just click on News Links. Jenny?